Yo, what's going on, everybody? Splash in the house, Third Eye Aesthetics, you know what it is. I just wanted to do a little dreadlock update video. Well, this is my first, so it's not exactly an update, but it's a dreadlock status video, I guess. So I got my hair done last December, man. I believe it was Christmas Eve. And the guy who did it goes by the name of Leith Stark. I'm gonna leave a link down here for you to contact him if you're interested in getting your dress done, or if you need some maintenance or whatever, or just need some just want to be a part of the culture or whatever, man. Like, I'm gonna leave a link down below. By the way, shout out to Leith, man. Thank you for letting me be a part of the Shiva tribe. Shanti, shanti, shanti. So before I show you guys what's going on up here, I just want to let y'all know that this is something that I've always wanted as a kid. You know, I've always wanted dreads, even when I was in high school. You know, I was, first time I saw them was not Bob Marley, but I got exposed to the whole concept of dreadlocks when I watched a Korn music video, and I was like, whoa, that is fucking cool. What is that? I need to have that. I wish I was this cool. Yeah, of course, man. Bob Marley happened. Fucking Rage Against the Machine happened. All these artists influenced me, and you know, and opened me up to the whole world of dreadlocks. And then the internet happened, Windows 98, fucking 95, all that shit, fucking dial-up internet connection and whatnot, man. We go all the way back to the 90s and that transition into the 2000s, and then 015, 016, 017, all of that, man. I've been molding myself into a certain kind of person, and I'm so thankful that I finally become a person who's ready to embrace the lifestyle, you know, because this is not only a hairstyle, as most dreadheads would tell you, but it is more of a lifestyle, you know, and it is a commitment. You know, once you go there, you don't go back unless you, I don't know, it's personal, it's different for different people. I guess it's best just kind of let it be. I personally feel that having dreads teaches you to let it go. You know, dreadlocks are all about letting it go. So let's get into it. What's up? No fucks given. Today is actually the perfect day to be filming this update, because I just gave them a wash today. It's when you wash them, you see maximum progress. You know what I'm saying? Like, you become aware of every single one of them and everything that every single lock has been through. You know what's going on. Like, you can actually feel like what's happening here. And it's beautiful. It feels so good. I love them. I love my dreadlocks. Yeah, man. So, neglect. A lot of neglect has been happening. I don't maintain them. I did some maintenance with Leith initially after I first got him. I think I went for like one session of maintenance, and that was it. You know, that was it. There was no more maintenance done after that. And I was just like, you know, just living life, keeping them clean. I wash them once a week. Yeah, I need to do that because I work out during the week. The scalp gets pretty fucked up over the week, and I need it. But sometimes, like, you know, it goes past 1 week, and that's when it kind of gets a little for shading, but it's still not bad. Like, you know, I can handle 2 weeks, nothing more. All right, let's get into it. You know, since I've been tying up my dreads, this is how I tied them up. You know, this is how I look on a daily basis. I have a little bun at the back, kind of like that, something like that. And I just be living life. I work out, do my thing, you know, walk around in the city or whatever, you know. Since I tie my dreads almost on a daily basis, I have a ton of lumps and bumps. I don't know if you can see it. There you go. A lot of lumps and bumps. Like, most of my dreads at the back, lumps and bumps. I actually love them. You know, it looks fucking silly, but it's dope. You know, it's dope. That's what makes them unique. I don't fucking want to crochet. Nah, it's alright, you know. The whole point of having dreads is that you don't give a fuck. You just let them be. And that's what I'm starting to learn with time. And that's what it's all about. That's what this lifestyle is all about. You know what I'm saying? Lumps and bumps. That's what life is like.
That's what life is really like. Bumps and bumps. It's all bumps and bumps. Bumps and bumps. The ones on the side, I've kind of started to mature a little, and I'm very happy with the progress out here. You know, I'm actually pretty surprised. Like, they look much better than what they did last month. I'm very proud of them. The ones in the front are usually always very loosely knotted up. I feel like they go through a lot of wear and tear. They go through a lot of bullshit. Even when I sleep, I don't wear any beanie because it's really hot in New Delhi right now. So I would just fucking sleep like this. Sometimes I sleep with my hair tied up. I don't really care. You know, I'm just living life. And when I take a shower, some of these locks in the front get wet almost every day. You know, I don't think that has anything to do with the progress, but I feel like they don't get enough time to sit and simply mature. You know, that's what I feel. But I'm okay with that, you know. And by the way, don't mind the ones trying to stand. Don't mind these guys. Like, I've been wearing a beanie all day, so they're just being a little weird. But it's cool. It's dope. It's dope regardless. See, more lumps and bumps happening out here. More lumps and bumps. I love that. Oh yes, this is something that I've been wanting to share. One of the main reasons why I wanted to do this video is because of these guys right here. Hang on, I'm gonna show you guys my first legit Congo. It's not legit yet, but it's almost there, and I'm very happy about it. I'm fucking stoked about this Congo right here. It's epic. If you look at the roots, the thing is, you guys, I don't know if you guys can see it, but the roots have started to lock themselves up together, and it's no longer two dreads, but it's slowly starting to become one dread. All that new growth, look at all that new growth. I don't know if you can see it. It's all one. This is eventually gonna become one dread. It's gonna grow out into one dread with like two little dreads at the end.
And that is fucking beautiful.
A couple more with some lumps and bumps out here. You see that? Well, most people would want to fix these up with a crochet hook, but I mean, I don't really care. I actually like the fact that there's this little donut. It's so not a donut, but whatever this thing is, I appreciate it because my dreadlocks represent my life, you know? It's everything that I've been going through. Life is not perfect. Life is not supposed to be perfect. And that is the only way you're gonna ever learn, is through these lumps and bumps. More lumps and bumps, you know? It's just how life is. And lastly, there's a lot of new growth. There is definitely a lot of new growth. You see that? All that hair in the front, that's my new growth. These are not locked hair. These are just normal hair growing out, which will eventually start locking up over time as they grow. Neglect them. I'm not gonna back comb them or crochet them, any of that shit. I'm just gonna let them be and just see what they look like over the year, you know. And I think it's gonna be fucking fun just watching them lock on their own. I want to experience freeform, because the more you read about dreadlocks, you will eventually realize that the real dreadlock is formed through neglect, freeform, that is. And you know, and that is what I want to personally experience now. This is more of a hairstyle, and now I want to go beyond that. I want to go beyond the hairstyle, and I feel like that is only going to happen when I neglect, for complete neglect, and let him freeform, you know. And I feel like that's going to be way more special. I don't mean to say like that this is not special, but I just feel like it's gonna be way more special when they freeform. So let's see what happens, you know. I'm gonna keep doing these updates and keep you guys posted on what's happening with my dreads and generally in life, with my workouts, my musical endeavors and whatnot, man. Thank you guys for connecting. I love you guys so much. I don't care about the numbers. I don't care if you're just like 5 people or whatever, man. I still love you. And thank you for being a part of Third Eye Aesthetics. You are all a part of this. We're all in this together, and we're all gonna be the best versions of ourselves. Together. Let's fucking get it. Hashtag gotta be the best. You already know all the links and whatever. Champion. I'ma be a champion. Nobody can stop me. Let go of the hate. Bring me in my room. Bring me in the stage. Bring me in the stage. Bring me on the stage. More lumps and bumps. I love that. Oh, yes.
this is something that I've been wanting to share.
One of the main reasons why I wanted to do this video is because of these guys right here. Hang on. I'm gonna show you guys my first legit Kango.
It's not legit yet, but it's almost there. And I'm very happy about it. I'm fucking stoked about this Kango right here. It's epic. If you look at the roots, the thing is, you guys, I don't know if you guys can see it, but the roots have started to lock themselves up together. And it's no longer two dreads, but it's slowly starting to become one dread. All that new growth. Look at all that new growth. I don't know if you can see it. It's all one. This is eventually going to become one dread. It's going to grow out into one dread with like two little dreads at the end.
And that is fucking beautiful.
A couple more with some lumps and bumps out here. You see that? Well, most people would want to fix these up with a crochet hook, but I mean, I don't really care. I actually like the fact that there's this little donut. It's so not a donut, but whatever this thing is, I appreciate it because my dreadlocks represent my life, you know? It's everything that I've been going through. Life is not perfect. Life is not supposed to be perfect. And that is the only way you're going to ever learn is through these lumps and bumps. More lumps and bumps, you know? It's just I like that you don't give a fuck. You just let them be. And that's what I'm starting to learn with time. And that's what it's all about. That's what this lifestyle is all about. You know what I'm saying? Lumps and bumps. That's what life is like. And that's what life is really like. Lumps and bumps. It's all lumps and bumps. Lumps and bumps. The ones on the side, I've kind of started to mature a little, and I'm very happy with the progress out here. You know, I'm actually pretty surprised. Like, they look much better than what they did last month. I'm very proud of them. The ones in the front are usually always very loosely knotted up. I feel like they go through a lot of wear and tear. They go through a lot of bullshit. Even when I sleep, I don't wear any beanie because it's really hot in New Delhi right now. So I would just fucking sleep like this. Sometimes I sleep with my hair tied up. I don't really care. You know, I'm just living life. And when I take a shower, some of these locks in the front get wet almost every day. You know, I don't think that has anything to do with the progress, but I feel like they don't get enough time to sit and simply mature. You know, that's what I feel. But I'm okay with that, you know. And by the way, don't mind the ones trying to stand. Don't mind these guys. Like, I've been wearing a beanie all day, so they're just being a little weird. But it's cool. It's dope. It's dope regardless. See, more lumps and bumps happening out here. Yo, what's going on, everybody? Splash in the house, Third Eye Aesthetics, you know what it is. I just wanted to do a little dreadlock update video. Well, this is my first, so it's not exactly an update, but it's dreadlock status video, I guess. So I got my hair done last December, man. I believe it was Christmas Eve, and the guy who did it goes by the name of Leith Stark. I'm gonna leave a link down here for you to contact him if you're interested in getting your dress done, or if you need some maintenance or whatever, or just need some just want to be a part of the culture or whatever, man. Like, I'm gonna leave a link down below. By the way, shout out to Leith, man. Thank you for letting me be a part of the Shiva tribe. Shanti, shanti, shanti. So before I show you guys what's going on up here, I just want to let y'all know that this is something that I've always wanted as a kid. You know, I've always wanted dreads, even when I was in high school. You know, I was, first time I saw them was not Bob Marley, but I got exposed to the whole concept of dreadlocks when I watched a Korn music video, and I was like, whoa, that is fucking cool. What is that? I need to have that. I wish I was this cool. Yeah, of course, man. Bob Marley happened. Fucking Rage Against the Machine happened. All these artists influenced me, and you know, and opened me up to the whole world of dreadlocks. And then the internet happened. Windows 98, fucking 95, all that shit, fucking dial-up internet connection and whatnot, man. We go all the way back to the 90s and that transition into the 2000s, and then 015, 016, 017, all of that, man. I've been molding myself into a certain kind of person, and I'm so thankful that I finally become a person. who's ready to embrace the lifestyle, you know, because this, these guys, this is not only a hairstyle, as most dreadheads would tell you, but it is more of a lifestyle, you know, and it is a commitment. You know, once you go there, you don't go back unless you, I don't know. It's personal. It's different for different people. I guess it's best just kind of let it be. I personally feel that having dreads teaches you to let it go. You know, the dreadlocks are all about letting it go. So let's get into it. What's up? No fucks given. Today is actually the perfect day to be filming this update because I just gave them a wash today. It's when you wash them, you see maximum progress. You know what I'm saying? Like, you become aware of every single one of them and everything that every single lock has been through. You know what's going on. Like, you can actually feel like what's happening here. And it's beautiful. It feels so good. I love them. I love my dreadlocks. yeah, man. So, neglect. A lot of neglect has been happening. I don't maintain them. I did some maintenance with Leith initially after I first got him. I think I went for like one session of maintenance and that was it. You know, that was it. There was no more maintenance done after that. Yeah. Now it's just like, you know, just living life, keeping them clean. I wash them once a week. Yeah, I need to do that because I work out during the week. The scalp gets pretty fucked up over the week and I need it. Sometimes, like, you know, it goes past 1 week and that's when it kind of gets a little for shading, but it's still not bad. Like, you know, I can handle 2 weeks, nothing more. All right, let's get into it. You know, since I've been tying up my dreads, this is how I tied them up. You know, this is how I look on a daily basis. I have a little bun at the back, kind of like that, something like that. And I just be living life. I work out, do my thing, you know, walk around in the city or whatever, you know.
Since I tie my dreads almost on a daily basis, I have a ton of lumps and bumps. I don't know if you can see it. There you go. A lot of lumps and bumps. Like, most of my dreads at the back, lumps and bumps. I actually love them. You know, it looks fucking silly, but it's dope. You know, it's dope. That's what makes them unique. I don't fucking want to crochet. Nah, it's tight. You know? The whole point of having dreads.